We did some good business. We were very pleased, and I don't think they would have been here had it been not for the French Quarter Festival, so we're really happy.
Some local business owners enjoyed record-breaking sales this weekend, and they say they owe it all to the French Quarter Festival. Good evening. Happy Sunday. Thanks for joining us. I'm Rachel Wolf. The three-day festival wrapped up just a few hours ago, but many say its impact on local businesses, well, far from over. WDSU News Channel 6 reporter Richie Angelico joins us live from the French Quarter with tonight's big local story. Good evening, Richie.
Good evening, Rachel. Well, by all accounts, the French Quarter Festival was a tremendous artistic and financial success. But first, let's show you how it all wrapped up with New Orleans' own Kermit Ruffins.
Let's party New Orleans style, yeah!
What a way to end the French Quarter Festival with Kermit Ruffins and that magic trumpet. But then, there has been a lot of magic at this year's French Quarter Festival. Magical, magnificent weather, record-breaking crowds, and folks spending lots and lots of money.
It's just been a constant stream of customers.
Le Petit Soldier Shop, now the Sword and Pen, has always been a favorite for its miniature soldiers. Here you can buy everything from a British general to the man who saved our city from the Redcoats in 1812.
We're sold out of Andrew Jackson. Can't find any more of him. And John Lafitte is a big one. You know, the Confederates from New Orleans, the Tigers of Juarez, have sold out.
Just a few blocks away, New Orleans artist Martin Laborde's famous elf-like figure, Bodo, walks on alligators, flies through space, and according to gallery manager Joy Eberly, has been flying out the door.
We've done over 10,000 today.
Wow.
So it's been very good, yes. The festival has been good to us.
We've had some great business, tremendous crowds.
Andrew Fields is the manager at M.S. Rao, one of the quarter's premier antique shops. It is proof that the festival draws big business and big spenders to New Orleans.
We were very fortunate over the course of the last couple of days to have some great sales, including a first-time client yesterday who spent well into the six figures. So we're obviously very pleased. We think it's great for the city.
Everywhere you look, people are carrying shopping bags. Sandra Fanouf came from St. Louis and found her favorite artist that opened a gallery here.
I've been buying his work for many a years when I first met him in St. Louis many years ago, and he's here with his family living, and so he just opened a new gallery, so I stopped in to get this new book that was ready to go right before Katrina hits.
In New Orleans, records are measured not only in sales but by the volume of trash. And when one wants to talk trash, why not go to the expert?
It's record-breaking as far as the amount of people that showed up to the French Quarter Fest. And as far as beer sales, it's record-breaking beer sales. And I can tell you one thing, those garbage trucks are telling us it's record-breaking trash.
Now, I want you to check this out. About an hour ago, this field behind me here was covered with trash. And now it looks like the front lawn at the governor's mansion in Baton Rouge. Well, it's all been a lot of fun for a lot of folks for the past several days, but now the planning begins again for number 26. And let's hope it's as big a success as this one. On your side from Waldenburg Park, I'm Richard Angelico, WDSU, News Channel 6.
Sidney Torres doing his job, huh, Richie?
Yes, indeed.
Thanks so much. Nice job.